we studied the implementation of array using stack using array. After that, we have seen the applications, different applications of stack. Few of them are reversing a given string using stack. Another is to convert any decimal number to binary. How do you convert a decimal number to binary? We successively divide that decimal number by 2 and we write the remainders aside in each and every step. At last, we do this process till the quotient becomes 0. We continue this process till the quotient becomes 0. And at last, we arrange the remainders from bottom to top to get the exact binary equivalent for a decimal number. We can do this program. We can do this conversion with the help of stack. Just assume that the remainders that we are getting in each and every step, we are pushing that elements, that remainders into the stack. Then what will happen? The first remainder that came into the process will go to the bottom of the stack. Then the next remainder on top of it, and the next remainder on top of it, and so on. This process continues till the last remainder came into the stack, and which will be placed on the top of the stack. At last, what you have to do is you have to perform pop operation on the stack. Then you will get the exact binary equivalent for a given decimal number. So that is a simple application of stack, where we actually convert any decimal number to binary number. Then the third application that we have seen is conversion of infix expression to postfix expression. Conversion of infix expression to postfix expression. There we have seen how to convert any given infix expression to postfix expression. What do you mean by infix expression? Any expression in which the operator comes in between operands, then that is called an infix expression. All mathematical expression that we write are considered as infix expression, because in those expressions, the operators are always comes in between operands. What do you mean by prefix expression? An expression in which the operator comes before the operand, that is called as prefix expression. And what do you mean by post expression? An expression in which all the operators in the given expression comes at last after operands, then that is called a postfix expression. If you see this box, then this, they are given the example of prefix, infix, and postfix expression. So from this you can understand what do you mean by prefix, infix, and postfix expression. Then in the conversion of infix to postfix, the precedence of operators always has the importance, where the higher precedence operation should happen before the lower precedence operation. In the process of conversion, I have given you an example where we converted one infix expression to postfix expression. Now the rule is, we scan the string. Suppose this is the expression I want to convert, that is A plus B into C from infix to postfix. Then we are applying this algorithm to convert any infix to postfix expression. We scan the string from our given mathematical expression from left to right. We prepared 4 columns in this table. The first column is your input, that is infix expression, and the last column is the output column, that is postfix. Intermediate column is the place where we actually keep the symbol which is scanned in every step, whether it may be an operator or it may be a character or in a operands. Okay. Third column is operator stack, where we actually record the operators that are coming in the expression. We put all the operators into the operator stack. So we'll apply the algorithm, the steps to convert this infix expression to postfix. We scan this from left to right. So the first symbol scan is A, and we found that A is an operand, so directly put it into the last column. Then the next symbol scan is plus, So we found that it is an operator. It must go into the operator stack. So we put it into operator stack. See this? Here is the plus symbol in the operator. The next symbol coming is B. B is operand, right? It should go into the last column, postfix expression. So it is placed into the last column. Then the name ball scan is multiplication. Can we put a multiplication over plus in this conversion? Yes, we can put any higher precedence operator over lower precedence operator in the stack. But the vice versa is not possible. The reverse is not possible. You cannot put a lower precedence operator over a higher precedence operator in the stack. But that is not the case here. Here, the coming operator is having higher precedence, whereas the upper element is having lower precedence. So I can easily put higher precedence operator, that is multiplication on top of plus into the stack. That is valid. So we did that. We put multiplication over plus, and at last the last symbol scan is C, which is also operand. It must go into the last column. So that becomes ABC in the last column. Okay. Now there is nothing into the first column for scanning. End of the string reached. That's why there is nothing into the remark column also, because there are no elements for scanning also. And if your stack is not empty, suppose if there are no symbols for scanning, the last steps come into the picture. If there are no symbols for scanning and if your stack is not empty, then you have to empty the stack by applying the principle of stack pop operation. Which element will go out of this stack first? That is multiplication. Then the next element, that is plus. So like this, all these elements are popped from the stack and you get your actual postfix expression for a given infix expression. Okay. There is another example that we have seen in the last lecture, that is an expression, infix expression, which has the brackets, parentheses. And you know that in the mathematical expression, parentheses plays an important role, where we need to give the higher precedence to all the parentheses. Means the parentheses or the brackets must be solved first. So even though this plus, the bracket, has less precedence than multiplication, in the entire expression, this C plus D has to be performed first. Operator precedence change the conversion result. Now we'll see here in this example how to convert this infix expression to postfix expression. The expression given is A into B minus in bracket C plus D, close the bracket. Okay. Again, we'll prepare four columns here. The first column is your input expression, last column is output expression. We scan this string character by character and we find the first symbol scanned is A, which is operand, goes last into the last column. The next symbol coming is multiplication. It should go into the operator stack because it's the operator. We put it here into the third column. Then the next symbol coming is B. It is an operand. It should go into the last column. Next symbol is coming is minus. Now see this. This situation is very, very important into this problem. Can we put a minus on top of multiplication into the stack? We can't. We cannot put a lower precedence operator, that is minus in this case. The lower precedence operator cannot be put on higher precedence operator. In that situation, you have to first pop out all the elements. You have to first pop out all the elements from the stack into the last column, that is postfix string. And then only you can move or you can shift this minus, which is having less precedence, into the stack. So we popped multiplication and later we put this minus into the stack. After minus, the next symbol scanned is opening parenthesis. We consider opening parenthesis an operator, so we put it into the operator stack. The next symbol coming is plus, sorry, C. So it is operand, it should go to the last column. It is here, A into B, AB into C, AB into C. Then the next symbol coming is plus, it should go into the stack because plus is having higher precedence than minus. It should go on top of that. Then the next symbol is coming is D, it should go into the last column because it is operand. So the expression between AB into CD. The last symbol coming to the scan column is closing parenthesis. Now what to do? Whenever the closing parenthesis comes, we have to check the topmost element of the stack. if this closing parenthesis matches the topmost element of the stack with the opening parenthesis, then we cancel that and we'll discard. But in this case, the topmost element is plus into the stack. If you see, topmost element is plus, whereas the coming element is closing parenthesis, it is not matching. So I have to pop all the elements from the stack into the postfix string till the topmost element becomes opening parenthesis. So in this case, we pop plus and then opening parenthesis comes on the top. Then this closing parenthesis and opening parenthesis gets matched. So it cancels and it gets discarded. At last, you have only one element remain into this stack, that is minus. And there are no elements for scanning into the first column. If you see, it is end of the string reached. There are no elements for scanning and your stack is not empty. And the last step comes into the picture where we actually empty the stack by popping all the elements from the stack to the last column. Here minus goes into the last column. And this is your actual postfix expression for the given infix expression. So this way we can convert any infix expression to postfix expression. The next application is very, very important. This much portion we have covered in the last lecture. Now we'll move to the another important application of stack is called as postfix evaluation. Evaluation of postfix expression. Okay, before that, I'll show you an animated video where you can understand what is the conversion or how to convert any infix to postfix expression. See this video. Here is the operator stack. This is the input expression and this is the output expression which will be stored into postfix vector. In this video, you will learn through this animation how to convert any infix expression to postfix expression. And we are going to apply all the rules that we have studied in the lecture. So the first element which will come into the expression is opening parenthesis. It must go to the stack because it is considered as operator in the conversion. And if any operator comes, we directly put it all the operands into the postfix expression. Whenever the operator comes, we check the precedence of the coming operator. And if it is having higher precedence than the topmost element of the stack, then we directly put it into the stack. And if the reverse thing occurs, it means if the coming element is having less precedence than the topmost element of the stack, then we cannot put. We have to pop all higher precedence operators from the stack to the postfix expression, and then we move that lower precedence operator into the stack. We push that lower precedence operator into the stack. We continue this process till the last element of the stack is reached, and then at last we check if there are no elements for scanning, and if your stack is not empty, then we have to empty the stack. Here is the thing. The first element is scanned and it is placed here into the stack. Check it. Carefully observe this video. See what things are happening here. A is operand, directly go to postfix. Plus is operator, must go to operator stack. It comes on top of opening parenthesis into the stack. B is operand, directly goes into postfix expression. Minus, I cannot put minus over plus because minus has less precedence than plus. So we have to first pop out plus and then put minus into the stack. Minus came into the stack. Now C is opened. Directly goes into last column, that is postfix expression. Now closing parenthesis. Whenever closing parenthesis comes, we always match that closing parenthesis with the topmost element of the stack. And if it is not matching, then we have to pop out all the elements from the stack to the postfix expression column till the closing opening parenthesis become the topmost element of the stack. So minus will go out of the stack and that will be placed into the postfix string. And opening and closing parenthesis get cancelled because topmost element is opening parenthesis and then closing parenthesis coming, that is matching and that gets cancelled. Multiplication is operator directly goes into operator stack. D is operand, it must go into postfix expression. Minus, can I put minus over multiplication? Minus having less precedence than multiplication, I cannot put minus over multiplication into the stack. So I have to first pop out higher precedence operator, that is multiplication, from the stack to the postfix expression, and then only I can move minus into the stack. Now minus is here in the stack. Now the next element coming is opening parenthesis, that goes into the stack. Then E is operand, it is placed here. Plus is operator with higher precedence than all these elements, so it can be placed into the stack. So it goes into the stack. F is operand, directly goes to postfix expression. Now the closing parenthesis come. Then what to do? We have to pop out a plus from this stack here so that this opening parenthesis becomes the topmost element and it gets cancelled. At last, there are no elements for scanning. So your stack is not empty, empty the stack by popping out minus in, from here to the last column. So this is the actual is postfix expression for given expression, infix expression to us. This way we can convert any infix expression to postfix expression. This video is very, very important. This topic is very, very important for your examination. There is definitely a question. There will be a question on conversion of infix expression to postfix expression for 10 to 15 marks, or it may vary in short notes. If it is asked, it will be for 5 marks. They may give you an expression and ask you to convert that expression into postfix expression, infix expression to postfix expression. Now the important application, the next important application is to find out conversion of the solution of any given infix expression, postfix expression. Okay, so the last application today we are going to see is evaluation of any postfix expression. What is the evaluation? It means an postfix expression is given to you and your job is to solve that expression and tell the answer. Okay, so we are going to use the stack. We are going to take the help of stack to solve any postfix expression. It is difficult for us to find the solution or the result of any postfix expression just by looking at it, right? Now if you see this expression given to you, 5, 6, multiplication, 7, 9, plus, minus, like this, any expression they may give you and ask you to find out the what is the result of this. It is very difficult because we don't know what is the sequence of operators that are coming into the expression, right? Then it is difficult to solve that expression. If you don't know this sequence of operators, which how they are coming into the expression, then it is difficult for solving. So how this stack will help us to solve this expression, we'll see. Again, solve any postfix expression. We'll scan the string or given postfix expression from left to right. So here we'll go from left to right. We found the element as the operand. So we prepared an operand stack. Instead of operator stack, in this example, we are going to see operand stack. Correct. So operator stack is not there in this calculation. Here we need operand stack. So all the operands must go into the stack directly. So 5 is operand, it goes into the stack. 6 is operand, it goes into the stack. After that, when multiplication, whenever the operator comes in the expression, we have to pop out the topmost two elements. We have to pop out topmost two elements and we have to perform the operation. Here in this case, which will be your first operand for multiplication, and which will be a second operand for multiplication. So if you see this stack in step one, there are only two elements. We have to pop out these two elements. 5 becomes operand 1, whereas 6 becomes operand 2. It means always the topmost element is the second operand in the expression for performing, and second last element of the stack is your first operand for performing that operation. So it means that I have to perform an expression, I have to solve an expression 5 into 6. It should not be 6 into 5, okay? It should be 5 into 6. It doesn't matter in case of multiplication, but it matters in case of minus, okay? Subtraction. So always remember this thing. Your topmost element is your second operand, whereas the second last element of the stack is your first operand. So the multiplication happens like 5 into 6. And whatever may be the result of this multiplication, it must be again pushed into the stack. So we put that result of multiplication into the stack. In step 2, if you see here, it is showing 30. Now, again, we'll continue our process of scanning. The next element coming is 7. 7 should go on top of 30. The next element coming is 9. So it will also go on top of 7. So in step number 3, you'll find a stack position after inserting 7 and 9. Now there are three elements into the stack, and the coming element is plus. Coming symbol is plus. It means you have to pop out two elements, topmost two elements, and you have to perform addition. So it is like 7 plus 9. The addition happens like 7 plus 9, and the result is 16. It is again pushed into the stack on top of 30. Now this is the picture of stack after performing addition operation. The next element that coming in the scan is minus. So we have to perform subtraction here, and the subtraction happens like 30 minus 16. It should not be 16 minus 30. First operand is 30, and second operand is 16. Means 30 minus 16 will be performed, and then the result will be pushed into the stack. In the step number 5, you can see 30 minus 16 is 14, and it is placed into the stack, which is your result, because you reach to the last element of the string during scanning. It means there are no elements for scanning, and if your stack is not empty, which has only one element, if the stack consists of that element, which that element is your result. It is the solution of your problem. So 14 is the result of this expression. Is it okay, students? Do you have any questions? Because the next problem has so many operators, so many examples. Then we'll see how to solve such a big expression using stack. Any doubts, students, till this point? Evaluation of any postfix expression using stack. If you have any doubt, you can ask me into the chat room. Mute your mic and ask. For 1 minute, you can ask your doubts. Any doubt, students? Write something into the chat room so that I will come to know whether you understood how to convert any conversion of infix expression to postfix, and then evaluation of postfix expression. Any questions, students? Write the answer into the chat. So if you understood, please write understood. There are no doubts. I want the answer from all the students. So write something into the chat room so that I'll come to know whether you understood or not. I'll take a question which is asked by Bharat Chaudhary. At the end, stack is destroyed. Yes, because stack is empty. It doesn't have any elements. So we can destroy it. Right. So that means you understood, all of you, correct? We'll move to the second example of it to better understand how to solve any
postfix expression.
In the second example, if you see here, there are so many operators and operands. Then how to solve such a particular expression? We'll apply the same thing. Only the arrangement is different here. In step number one, it shows how many steps are required to solve this. In second, we have the symbol column where we actually scan one symbol from the expression and we'll put it into this column. And last column is your operator stack where we operand stack. It is operand stack. By mistake, it is written operator stack. It is actually operand stack. Okay. So we have to put all the operands in the last column. Just ignore this operator work. By mistake, it is there. It is operand stack. Okay. So we will pick, check this diagram and this table. The first element coming is 7, 6. So it goes into the stack because operand. It goes into operand stack. 7 is also operand. 5 is also operand. 3 is also operand. So if you see, they are placed one after the another. 6, 7, 5, 3. Which is the topmost element here? It is 3. Because the current element that you insert is in the insert is 3. It means this stack is growing from left to right. The stack is growing from left to right. The topmost element is 3 now, whereas the bottommost element is 6 of the stack. Now the next element that is caret symbol. What is the caret symbol? In general, it is used for finding the power of a number. They are used for finding the power of a number. So what is 5 raised to 3? 5 raised to 3 is 125. It means that whenever this caret symbol comes, we have to pick the topmost two elements, that is 5 and 3 from the stack and perform the operation in computer's memory. The operation result is 125. 5 raised to 3 is 125. So it will be placed again into the stack. That result will be pushed back into the stack. The next element coming from the string is plus. So we put plus here. And now we have to pop topmost two element. So we pop 125 and 7. And we perform 7 plus 125. And the result will be again pushed into the stack. And the result is 132. There are only two elements now into the stack, and the coming element and symbol is multiplication. It means we have to multiply 6 into 132. We multiply these two numbers and we again put that result into the stack. The result is 792. After multiplication, the next symbol is operand plus another symbol is also 2. Another symbol is also 2. So we put this 2 on top because they are operands. We put it into operand stack. So it goes on top of 792, 2, 2. So the topmost element here is now 2 and the bottommost element is 792. Again, the next symbol coming is caret. Caret is nothing but you have to find the power of last two elements, 2 raised to 2. Here, we'll perform 2 raised to 2. 2 raised to 2 is 4 and again the result will be placed into the stack. The result is 4. So we have two elements into the stack, that is 792 and topmost element is 4. The next symbol is 8, the next symbol is 4. Both are operands, it must be placed into the stack. If you see, the first symbol 8 came, then we put it here on top of 4. The next symbol is 4, that goes on top of 8. So now we have 4 elements into the stack and 4 is the topmost element of this stack. The next symbol coming from the expression is division. So it means we have to perform divide of two numbers, last two elements, 8 by 4. What is 8 by 4? It is 2, 8 by 4 is 2, so that 2, the result that came, we place in this stack. And now the stack consists of element 792, 4, 2. The next element coming is multiplication. It means we have to perform multiplication of last two elements. 4 into 2 is 8. It will be placed into the stack, the result. And the last element coming from the expression is plus. It means we have to perform addition here. So we perform addition of 792 and 8, and the result of these two operands in addition process is 800. We push that result into the stack, that is 800. And now there are no elements for scanning. The end of the string is reached. The end of the string is reached. It means the element which is there in the stack, is your result of this expression. So this way we can perform or solve any postfix expression to using stack. So this is the way we can solve any postfix evaluation. Okay. Any questions, students, in this second example, do you have any questions? Please write your question in the chat room. In the practicals, we'll going to study the programs on infix to postfix conversion and a program on postfix evaluation. So three programs are very, very important into this chapter, that is implementation of stack using array. Second is infix to postfix conversion. And third is postfix evaluation. I want you to practice these three programs at your home, and we'll again perform these programs into the practicals. Any doubts, students? No. I got someone on, no doubts. Okay. So this ends your chapter of stack. Okay, my question now. Just quickly, I will ask you some questions and you have to answer your question into the chat room. Okay, answer the question in the chat room. The first question that comes is, how do you check the stack is full or not when you implement stack using array? How do you check whether the stack is full or not when you implement stack using array? Okay, top equals to n minus 1. What is n here? It is size of the array, or max minus 1, which is the size of the array. Correct. Good. So this way we can check. Good. The next question is, how do you check whether the stack is empty or not when you implement stack using array? All your answers gets recorded. I want the answers from all the students. So when question is asked, within 1 minute you have to give the answer. So we have seen two questions. One is stack overflow condition and stack underflow condition. What is the drawback of array implementation? Anyone? What is the drawback of array implementation? Third question is, what is the drawback of array implementation? Okay. I'm getting very good answers. Anybody wants to add to this answer? What is the drawback of array implementation? You can write your answer into the chat. Everything is recorded. I'll check all these answers later on. So the answer is, here I have received from many students, is the size of the array is fixed. That's why you cannot change the size of the array at runtime. It is fixed. Means limited number of elements you can insert. But how many elements we can insert? Only the size of the array. The size of the array. If the size of the array is 5, I can insert only 5 elements into the array. I cannot insert 6th element. Size limitation, first point. Then insertion and deletion is a tedious job. Yeah. Bharat has given that answer. That is also technically correct. Third is Srinivas Patel. Very nice answer given by him. Wastage of memory happens whenever you perform insertion or deletion into the array. Now, how the wastage occurs? Check an example. Suppose you have an array of five elements, say, where there are five different locations where you can insert the elements into the stack or elements into the array. Consider you have only two elements into the array. You have only two elements into the array and three locations are empty. And two locations are filled with the values, whereas three locations are empty. Both of these three locations memory gets wasted. Even though there is only one element, the array takes full memory required for its implementation. Means if the array of five size of integers, then it will take 10 bytes of memory, computer's memory. Even though there is one element, it again takes 10 bytes of memory. If there are five elements, still it takes 10 bytes of memory. If there are three elements, still it gets 10 bytes of memory. It doesn't matter how many elements are there into the array. It will take whole memory. So definitely there is a memory wastage whenever you use array for implementation of any structure. Now Shreyas Parkar has written something here. We have to increment all the time the memory location to store the value which is not in the case of stack. Okay. It means always we need to increment or decrement. We have to take the help of some another pointer or variable for doing this operations. I will check any other answer that apart from this you people have given. Okay, no. These are three questions. You can note down the question that I asked because same type of questions may have come into your online examination during your exam. If you can find, there are MCQs where the question is asked, four options are given to you. You have to pick the answer and you have to give the answer. Okay. Now tell me the answer of the fourth question. What is infix expression? Give one example. Example of any infix expression. Write it fast. Example of any infix expression. In 1 minute, you have to write your answer. Good, very good examples that you are giving here. Any expression in which the operators comes in between operands, it's called infix expression. So I have received so many answers where you are given the infix example, right? This is the fourth question that I asked you. Next question, fifth question is, Give me one example of prefix expression. Write the example of prefix expression. Oh, good. Okay, now the next question. Give me an example of postfix expression. Any one postfix expression. Do it fast. Good. So I received the answers of sixth question. Seventh question. Now listen carefully. Seventh question is, in the case of, listen carefully, in case of conversion of infix to postfix expression, you have to tell me the answers in true or false. Yes or no. Okay. Your answer may be true or it may be false only. That's it. In the case of, now the question is, in the case of conversion of infix to postfix conversion, can we put a higher precedence operator on top of lower precedence operator? Okay, your answers from many students. Yes, we can put any higher precedence operator which is coming in the scan symbol on top of the lower precedence operator. Anytime you can push higher precedence operator on top of lower precedence operator, there is no harm. We can easily do that. Now the next question coming is, again, in the conversion process of infix to postfix, listen carefully. The question is, in the conversion of infix to postfix, can we put lower precedence operator on top of higher precedence operator which is available into the stack? You can also write all the questions that I asked to you. Okay. Now the next question coming is, if we cannot put a lower precedence operator or higher precedence operator, to solve this problem of not putting a lower precedence operator on higher precedence operator, what we do? What we have to do to solve this problem? You people are writing pop. Pop means what? Means which elements you will pop? This is a very important step. Sachit has written something good. Shivani also correct. But again, you can elaborate it if possible. How to solve the problem of not putting lower precedence operator into the stack on top of higher precedence operator? Is it only the operator precedence or any other thing that you do? How to resolve that problem? lower than in the stack. Okay. Shivan has given some answer, which is near to the correct answer. Okay. Shivas Patel, pop topmost operator and put that operator into the Postgres expression. It is half then, Shivas. It is only half answer. Okay, I answer to this question. How to resolve the problem of not putting lower precedence operator on top of higher precedence operator? It means you cannot put a lower precedence operator on top of higher precedence operator. Whenever this case comes in the conversion of infinite to postfix expression, we have to pop out, listen carefully, we have to pop out all the higher precedence operator from the stack. We have to pop out all higher precedence operators from the stack to the postfix expression, correct? And then only we can push a lower precedence operator into the stack. Okay. So if it is done, then the next question is, in the conversion of infix to postfix expression, which stack we use? Is it a operator stack or it is an operand stack? You have two options. One is operator stack, another is operand stack. In the conversion of infix to postfix conversion, which stack we use? Operator stack or operand stack? Okay, good. You understood the conversion means, right? So we use operator stack in the conversion of infix to postfix. The next question now is on the fourth application that we have studied, evaluation of your postfix expression. Which type of stack we use? Is it the operator stack or operand stack in conversion of, sorry, in the evaluation of postfix expression? Which stack we use? Now the next question, and again the fourth application of stack is evaluation of postfix expression. Answer is correct, all of you. It is operand stack. Now during the evaluation of postfix expression, whenever the operator comes, what we do? Whenever the operator comes into the scan symbol, what we do? In evaluation of postfix expression, when the operator comes, what we do? Thank you. Now I like the answer given by Shreya Bijam. She said, perform operation on top two elements and then push the answer into the stack. Again, Nilesh Rawod has written the same thing. Pop two elements, perform the operation and then push the result back into the stack. Okay, so you have to complete your answer always. Remember this thing. Most of you have written the correct answer. And Tushar is saying me too. Yes, you also. So we have seen the conversion applications of stack, and then we check through these questions whether you understood or not. I'm sure you understood both the applications, important applications of stack, conversion of infix to postfix and evaluation of postfix expression. Okay. So here we end the